All right, so with a power clean and clean pulls or clean grips, clean grip exercises, clean grip is typically what you use for a traditional bench press, slightly wider than shoulder width grip. Snatch grip is much wider than that. So a good rule of thumb for picking the snatch grip is to flex your elbows to 90 degrees and then reach down and grab a bar. And so now my hands are wider than the traditional clean grip. I may shift my hands out slightly or in slightly based on comfort. It might put a little bit of stress on the wrist joint. So adjusting a little bit, either closer or a little further apart. But a good starting place is to flex the elbows to 90 degrees when you grip the bar. Okay? So for the first exercise that we're going to do in trying to teach the power clean, is to start the clean grip on the bar, and we're just going to start standing in an upright position. The thing to remember about cleans and snatches is the intensity of effort. And so what we want to do is think about a vertical jump. Think about the intensity in which we perform a vertical jump. That's the intensity in which you're performing all of the variations and exercises that involve the snatch and the clean. So the first one is simply a jump with the bar and then shrug the shoulders. So again, the intensity is to jump as high as you can and then shrug. So jump, shrug, okay? And we can do the same thing with the snatch. So from the hang here, jump, shrug, okay? You wanna give that a shot?
Sure.
Foot placement. Where should my feet be?
So think about a traditional back squat exercise. Feet are slightly wider than shoulder width. Toes are pointed maybe just a slight bit out. There you go. That's it. Thing to remember is if you notice when you're shrugging, the bar is kind of swinging out from you just a little bit. And so what we want to do is try to keep the bar in close to the body, touching the body at all times. That's better. Okay, so I notice that you're jumping backwards a little bit. That barbell behind you there is getting closer and closer. So safety first, let's just go ahead and push that barbell off the platform so we don't have to worry about it. Same thing for any place that would be on the platform. We want to clear our space so we don't hurt ourselves. All right, so let's see the snatch. There you go. Again, the bar is kind of moving just a little bit out from you, keep it in close. There you go. Good. All right, so the next one is to do what's called that's just a snatch grip pull from the hang. So now what we're gonna do is jump, shrug, and then we're gonna let the momentum that we generated from that jump allow the bar to travel. So we're just gonna flex the elbows. I'm not really pulling upward with the bar with my arms. I'm just flexing them, allowing the bar to move vertically. So it's gonna be, do a snatch grip here. So jump, shrug, and then let them come up. Okay, same thing for the clean. I'm going to start here. Jump, shrug. That wasn't a very good high pull. Okay. Now, the PVC pipe is extremely light, and so it kind of throws off the timing. So, you may want to try a little bit of a weight in your hands here. So, I do a clean grip here. Okay. Now, again, I'm going to try to keep the bar in as close as possible. So, snatch grip here. Make sure to shrug as well. All right, so let's do that shot. Now try the snatch. Same thing, wider. So you notice how you're laying on the heels of your feet there? You're jumping backwards every single time, and that's causing you to land on your heels, which is throwing your balance off. So try to remember to jump straight up into the air. That was better. Good. Okay. So that is from the hang. So now what we're going to do is change our starting position. So here, I'm going to start mid-thigh. So same grip, clean grip. I'm going to start in upright position. My torso is upright. Think about sticking the chest out like you're doing back squat exercise. And now I'm just going to flex the knees and the hips to lower the bar so that it's in the middle of my femur. Okay? So now I'm going to jump and shrug. So jump, shrug. Okay? So again, the bar should slide right up the thigh. The idea is to get the bar to the top of the femur, as close to the top of the femur as possible, before you shrug. Okay? So here it is from the sagittal here. Okay? And of course we can do the same thing with the snatch grip. Starting here.
Here?
Yes. So that time, you kind of thrust your hips forward, and that calls the bar to swing out. So remember, we want the bar to go straight up. That was better. There you go. So remember, with these, our elbows are fully extended here. There you go. All right, try to snatch it. Good. There you go. Make sure the elbows are fully extended here. We don't want to bend the elbows just yet. There you go. Good. All right, same thing now, but high pull. So now we're going to do the same thing. When I get to the shoulder shrug, I'm going to flex the elbows and allow the momentum of my jump to carry the bar vertically. So it should slide right up along your shirt.
As far as my torso, when I am coming to mid-thigh, should I more RDL to mid-thigh?
We're going to keep the torso.
More half squat to mid-thigh.
More, I think, like a quarter squat kind of position. So my torso is vertical.
Here?
Yep. That time we wanted to swing the bar out away from us.
Oh, where
it should slide right at the thigh. That was a little bit better. There you go. Again, we want to try to let it slide as far up the thigh as possible. There you go. Excellent. All right, we're going to try a snatch grip.
Here.
talk about the snap. So now what we're going to do is start moving further down the leg. So this was our mid-thigh pull. Now we're going to start moving from down here. Okay? So I'm going to put a little bit of weight on the bar just to kind of elevate the bar so it's in a better position for me. And all I'll do is just get the bar up off the floor. Now what we're going to do is think about our deadlift starting position. So I'm starting in this very down position. Okay? So I've got the bar right up on my shins, my butt's nice and low. I'm going to stick my chest out, and now I'm just going to stand up with the bar and then jump and shrug. Okay? So if you'll notice, see if I can what's going to happen is as I'm coming up, the knees are moving backwards, and then I'm going to let the bar slide up the thigh. So it's going to be like this. Okay? So again, jump and shrug. Okay? So we can do the same thing with the snatch grip, since we're just talking pulls here. So I'll start with a wider grip.
So let's move it this way really quick because.
Move it.
Leave the camera.
Oh, move one.
Yep. Yeah. And now when I teach the deadlift, I'm teaching it like a powerlifter with very vertical shin angle, hips relatively high. So and when I was watching you, you have a greater shin angle, so you have more of a clean grip, or yes. A clean setup, I guess.
Yeah, so think about the bottom position and back squat.
Yeah.
So that might be a better...
So my feet are a little wider apart than a traditional deadlift.
Right.
And my hips are lower, my shin is at a greater angle, and I'm trying to get my thigh to about...
Parallel,
give or take?
Yeah.
Okay.
Think and remember, that position is back biomechanics. We're going to keep the back flat.
Mm-hmm. So we have more of an upright torso versus...
Correct.
Yeah, okay.
So just, not high pulls yet, just jump and shrug. So we want to let the bar slide up the thigh, not just bounce off the middle of the thigh. This leg's too light for you. That's what ultimately is happening because you're just bouncing off the thigh. This should just slide right up the thigh. But because it's too light, you're basically just standing up with it. And then having it bounce off the quadriceps to go up.
Even when I clean heavy weight,
you do the same thing?
It happens. I don't grow hair like right here on my thighs anymore from it.
I was the same way. I would take layers and layers of flesh off my shin and off my thigh.
Yeah. All right, so let's go through this in slow motion once again.
Now let it slide up. There you go.
And then from here,
that's it, that's it. So the trick is to put all that together and make it look fluid. Okay, now see if you can do that without pausing at that top end. Better. Remember to keep the elbows fully extended. Not really high pulls yet. There you go. Again, try to let the bar swing out. Now that was kind of an afterthought. Still want to
know that one hitting you right here.
Yeah, you'll probably have a bruise after a while.
Yeah.
Where it slams into the quadriceps. Try the same thing, but now snatch greater. So now we'll do the same type of thing, but high pull.
Okay.
So same starting position with clean. Nothing catches my shirt. And of course we can do the same thing with snatch. So we're getting our high intensity interval training. There you go. Now it's really the shrug and the momentum of the lower body is traveling more vertically. There you go. Now what we're going to do is the same series of progressions, starting from the hang and moving our way down the body, down the lower leg. We're going to start with a clean, power clean. This one's going to be from the hang. So remember our initial, starting with just the bar, jumping and shrugging. Now we're going to jump, shrug, high pull, and then I'm going to drop down to catch the bar in kind of a front squat position. So this is where shoulder flexibility becomes extremely critical. I want to hold on to the bar, but I want to make sure that my elbows are up as nice and high as I can get them when I catch it. If I catch like this, the momentum or the weight of the bar is going to pull me forward. And then I'm running all over the weight room trying to catch it. So I don't want to have that happen. So here I'm going to start from the hang. Again, jump, shrug, high pull, and then catch. So the elbows are up nice and high. The bar is almost choking me because it's up against my throat. But this is a much more stable position than this is. So we always want to get the elbows up nice and high. Notice that I'm not letting go of the bar either. My fingers are still wrapped around the bar. So again, drop a shrug. Okay. It's kind of hard to see with the plates in the way. So I rotated 45 degrees. Alright, so give that a shot. So jump, shrug, high pull, and then drop down to catch. That was good. So you didn't even have to drop down, so that was good. I mean, you used a lot of lower body power to drive the bar vertical. Good. Really powerful shrug is going to make that bar move even faster. There you go. So now we're going to do the same progression. We're just going to do the same thing, but I'm going to lower my starting position. So rather than mid, from the hang, I'm going to go down to mid thigh. Same series of progressions here. Jump, shrug, high pull, and then I'm going to drop down to catch it. So the things that typically go wrong here is I swing the bar out away from me, and then I'm catching like this, or the bar's going to crash into my throat, it's going to hurt a lot. So I always want to make sure the bar is sliding up the thigh. That means the bar is moving upward rather than swinging away from it. All right, give it a shot.
This position?
Yep. Okay. All right, so now we're going to do a power clean from the floor. Now, just kind of a point of reference here, power clean and clean are very similar. The difference is how low you go to catch the weight. With a clean, typically the load on the bar is so great that you can't catch it from this position, from a kind of a quarter squat position. So that means that you're going to have to drop all the way down to catch it. Whereas a power clean, the load's not as heavy, and so you kind of catch it in this kind of quarter squat position. Okay? So same basic reference here. This time we're going to start in that bottom back squat position. Again, same series of thoughts. Jump, shrug, high pull, and then drop down to catch.
Is there any benefit to trying catching it lower if you don't need to catch it lower? So you see, you can make the reference, but in CrossFit a lot, using submaximal weights, but catching it, like accelerating the bar to here, so we can probably catch it here, but catching it and then dropping all the way down with it and coming back up in terms of developing power.
If you're going to ultimately make the transition from a power clean to a clean, then practicing getting into that bottom position may be of benefit to enhance shoulder flexibility, to keep the elbows up, but also to recognize how low can you actually go and get comfortable at catching that level. That would be the only benefit that I can see.
Correct. That was terrible, right?
I've seen you do better, but I've also seen you do a lot worse. So that time it's bouncing consistently around mid thigh. You want it to get up a little bit higher if possible. And I think it might be if you had a lot more weight on the bar to force you to go into that position. So that's the power clean, and the progression from doing jump shrugs from the hang all the way down to the floor. We did a similar type of thing with the snatch, but before we do snatches from the hang, from the mid-thigh, from the floor, just like we did with the cleans, I think it's important to practice or get used to the catching position before we actually try to put it all together. So what I typically do next, I'm going to move this bar out of the way, is have the individual take a broomstick, or in this case PVC pipe, and what we're just going to do is an overhead squat. Have you got overhead squats before?
Mm-hmm.
So this would be a good starting place along with the snatch grip pulls from the hand. So we want to get used to having the bar straight up overhead and getting into this down position. And in fact, this might be a good warm-up for when you start to do weight with the power snatch. So we're getting all the way down, bar straight up overhead. Okay? Then once we got that down, the next exercise progression is what's called snatch balance. This is where you need to move as fast as possible. So here we're going to start in kind of this high bar, parallel back squat position, snatch grip this time. And what I want to do is try to keep the bar in the same spot and just drop down quickly to lock my arms out. So it should look like this. So I'm starting here. And so essentially, I'm dropping down and trying to keep the bar in the same spot. So as I'm moving down, I'm pushing up with my arms. Okay? So again, speed of movement is the key here. Okay? So we can do that. And then, of course, we can add weight once we get comfortable with that. And so this would be what it would look like with the weight. So I'm starting here. Kind of push forward on that. So, all right, your turn.
I used to be really good at these, but I have mobility.
It's amazing how fast that goes away. Head up, we'll look straight ahead. There you go. Now, the thing to remember is we want the bar straight up overhead, and if we start to pull the bar forward because we're losing our flexibility at our core, then we want to stop and not go any further until we gain that flexibility. There you go. All right, look straight ahead. The moment you start to drop your head and look down, you start to pull your arms forward. So with that, we also want to make sure that our elbows are fully extended the whole time. This becomes extremely critical when we start to do the power snatch, snatch from the floor, and so forth, because the bar's going to come crashing down our head if we don't. Good. All right, you want to try snatch balance?
Am I kind of starting it with a push press?
Kind of like a
or am I just
starting
dropping?
Like a high bar squat. So okay. That kind of starting position.
Right.
And the idea is to drop down as fast as you can while locking your elbows out. So essentially the bar should remain stationary.
Okay.
And you're just dropping down to get to that.
So no
position.
Like
right. There's no dip and drop. It's just straight down.
Got it.
It's not bad. Good. There you go. You also get a little deeper in your range of motion, which is good too. You want to travel a little bit away?
Sure.
Okay. I'm going to use
the just a bar up.
Okay. It's a big difference between using the PVC pipe and having a little bit of weight in your hands. But the same basic principle applies. Starting in the high bar squat position.
Mm-hmm.
High bar, that's not over, that's overhead squat.
I know.
You're just testing it though.
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
So as far as, I see this especially like on YouTube, with high schoolers doing massive power cleans.
And legs.
Yeah.
It's okay to jump out a little bit, and if you probably noticed in the videos that I do that a little bit as well.
Right.
But the idea is not to be excessive. You don't want to be out here doing like a sumo style deadlift position while you're trying to catch the squat.
Yeah.
Because that's going to make you very unstable in that anterior posterior direction. Good. You got it? Excellent. All right, so now what we're gonna do is put everything together. Now that the person is comfortable doing overhead squats, snatch rounds, they're getting good range of motion in that bottom position, and they're able to do snatch grip pulls from the floor, what we're gonna do is start with from the hand. And so we're just gonna do a power snatch from the hand. So here, we're going to start with our snatch grip. So from the hand, all I'm going to do is jump, shrug, high pull, and then I'm going to get into that overhead squat position. So essentially what I'm doing is as I have that high pull, I'm pulling myself under the bar to get into that overhead squat position. Okay? So it should look like this. Getting kind of lazy here. There we go. Okay? I'm going to loop from the side to there. So the bar should be pretty close. It's not swinging out away from me. It should go straight up. Okay? So give that a try. Shoulder shrug. Very good. Excellent. All right, so now let's try if you want to do one or the bars, then the bars face.
Sure.
And then we'll try one from mid top. So let's try now from mid-thigh. So same starting position as the clean, just snatch grip. So again, jump, shrug, high pull, and then drop down to get under the bar. Now, it may look like Dr. Cleve and I are using our arms to bring the bar up. That is not the case. It is the power generated from the quadriceps, hamstrings, and glutes, along with the traps from the shoulder shrug, that is driving the bar vertically. Okay. There's one from the side. Okay. Give that a shot.
good try. All right, so that reminds me to talk about safety. Sometimes we catch the bar and it's like right here in front of us. And sometimes we catch the bar and it's behind us. Usually those things are a consequence of us swinging our arm away from us. But regardless, if it's here and we can't hold on to it, we're going to keep our hands on the bar and let it come back down onto the platform. When our hands get below our waist, then we can let go. That's going to minimize the bouncing that's going to take place so it doesn't hurt anybody. With it going behind us, we're going to step it forward to get up and let it drop behind us. Okay? So, fortunately, we didn't have any of those issues, which is good. But yeah, something to think about, you can't really spot somebody doing power cleans and power snatches. And so that's how we keep ourselves safe. All right, so now that we've done from mid-thigh, I'm going to put a little bit of weight on the bar, so I'm going to get the one back here. Just to put a little bit more. So now we're going to start from the floor. So same basic premise. Start here, double knee bend, so the knees are moving back, and then forward to get out of the way of the bar. The bar's going to slide the thigh. High pull, short high pull, and then drop down to catch it.
Sure. Yeah, I want you to do one so we can see it on the angle too.
I think the place might obscure a lot of the movement. I'll do one with the end of the bar facing the camera. You're done. All right, so things to remember about the power snatch. If they don't have good balance in that overhead squat position, you're not going to be doing these power snatches.
Or shoulder mobility.
Yeah. Well, we can work on that. We can get it better. The next one is just the push press and then the push jerk. The push press, there's a progression to that as well, and that's just starting with a standing shoulder press. So here we're going to start in kind of this front squat position, and all I'm going to do is press the bar up overhead. So that's just our traditional standing shoulder press. The push press, same starting position. Now I'm going to dip and then drop like I'm jumping off the floor.
And that's going to take this bar vertically. And then my arms are also pushing at the same time. So it should look like this. Okay, so this key phrase there is dip and then drive. Dip, drive. Okay, so it's really the momentum created by the core here that's driving that bar vertically. So typically the load on the bar is a little bit more than what you can do with a standing shoulder press. Standing shoulder press, yep. Now try push press. There's a little bit of a second dip there, and that we don't want to have.
I understand.
That's it. But I know you're a lot stronger than that, so it should happen very quickly. There you go. So the load on the bar is usually what's going to drive how far down you dip. And those types of things. But generally speaking, we're not going to drop more than like a quarter squat starting position. So that's the push press. The last one is the push jerk. So this is going to require more load on the bar than what you can do with a push press. And so as a result, when I dip and drive, I can't lock my elbows out because it's too heavy. So what I'm going to do is dip a second time, lowering myself to lock my elbows out, and then stand up. Okay? So the sequence here is dip, drive, and then dip again. So dip, drive, dip. And then open the side here. Okay. Because the load is so light, you already locked your arms out before you dipped again. There you go. Good. That's all the exercises.
Sweet.
Hallelujah.